Hey guys, what's up? I'm here. I'm DrewBDoo, and this is
Soberoni,
and we're here for our first episode of Get Good.
Yeah.
Oh my god, it sounds like like I'm singing like something like from the country, like Get Her Done.
Yes, we are. So we're gonna be playing. I'm gonna be teaching DrewBDoo here how to get good at Dark Souls. We're gonna do the first game, and my job is to coach him through all the trials and tribulations associated with Dark Souls.
And my job is to die
a lot.
Wait, I can't use this.
No, you have to use the D-pad.
Oh my
this is
God,
the, all right. So keep in mind, this game was made in 2009. Which, actually, it looked really good for 2009, considering I have the fix enabled. You have to actually type in your name using the keyboard.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Yeah, male or female?
I'm gonna be a guy. Already selected for me.
Oh. Alright, for your class, as a beginner, I really, really, really recommend Pyromancer in Dark Souls 1.
I was a Pyromancer last time, and it didn't do much for me.
So, like, the way this works is if you scroll over the classes, you'll notice they all have a level. Yeah, okay. They all have a starting level, and if you are a pyromancer, you start at level 1, which means you have the most flexibility to branch off into whatever you want to do. But also, whatever you start off as is not going to be what you end as. Usually, you start off as something, and you halfway through the game become something else, because items and stuff happen. Plus, pyromancy in Dark Souls 1 is stronger than pyromancy in any of the other Dark Souls. So that's just my suggestion. Plus, I know how much you love spellcasting.
Like, I played Pyromancer last time, even though that
you
literally
played the Pyromancer
been
literally to halfway through the tutorial. Don't make it
sound
like
the
I did
end.
A whole playthrough of a Pyromancer.
To the end.
I don't even know if you got the Pyromancy spell in the beginning of the game.
I really, literally just wanted to pick the guy.
You can also. A knight or a warrior is good too.
I want to pick the guy who's like does bows and arrows, but apparently that
you can literally pick a pyromancer and still use bow and arrow.
Fine.
There's no restrictions other than stats. But no, by all means, pick warrior, knight, whatever.
Fine.
So you can pick one gift to start your journey with. Read through them. It really makes no difference. The only thing I will say is don't pick the master key, because you can game break by picking the wrong path, since you can open any door.
Ah. Ancient ring with no obvious effect. Is that like
old witch's ring and the pendant have no effect.
Ever?
Nope, they're just useless. The creator of the game actually trolled everybody by saying the pendant, even though the pendant says no effect in the gameplay. He said that in an interview that he liked to pick the pendant as a starting item all the time. So people went crazy for years trying to figure out if there was a purpose to it, and there's not. He just trolled everybody.
What a dick. I'm gonna get the tiny beings ring. Is this like a one-time
thing? Some of them are one-time, some of them are like attachable like items, like tiny beings ring you keep with you through the whole game.
Yeah.
Did you pick male? Because you kind of look female, like your character.
Yeah, it looks like that's hair, but I'm pretty sure that's like a cape.
Like, yeah, it's like a cloth, but I'm just saying, your face kind of looks feminine.
Top. Tiny
head.
Could be very influential, or just have a big ass head.
Big with brains.
Slow.
I feel like these are coded racist
terms. Yeah, right. Really, the black guy has to be known for festivity and drink? Okay. The Great Swamp. He looks so angry.
Far East Traveler.
Doesn't even look Asian. What the fuck? That was kind of racist.
It was racist. You want him to have squinty eyes?
Because I was thinking, I thought they were going to be racist because, you know, they made the festivity and drink person black, so you might as well just go hard or go home. Fuck. Oh, God. Get out, Kyrie.
My cat's scratching up the door.
Yeah, you know
she what? She wants no part of this game.
You know what? I'm gonna be a black guy. Why not?
You, at least you look like a happy black guy.
You know, he's not gonna be happy soon.
You'll die with a smile on your face.
Oh my god. Like, it looks like a perm that's just falling apart. A slightly better perm. Oh god. Kind of just be bald. Oh my god, look at all that chest hair, Jesus.
I guess that's part of the character. Maybe if you picked Asian, you wouldn't have had any chest hair. She gave him, like, gray silver hair so he could look like Sephiroth. Like a black Sephiroth. He'll be like a Sephiroth cosplayer.
Yeah. Alright. What is customized?
Customizes if you want to get ridiculous and, like, do nose size and eyebrow thickness.
Do I get piercings?
No.
Oh.
This is 2009. That was way ahead of its time.
In the age of ancients, the world was unformed, shrouded by fog. A land of grey crags.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, guys.
Trees.
I kinda don't care about the story.
Everlasting dragons.
He will. He will by the end of it.
I don't know, it's very medieval-ish.
So my goal for this, there was fire. Aside from teaching Drew to be good or get good is to figure out a lot about the lore that I don't know, because there's a ton of shit I don't know.
And cold.
Why is it up to me?
And death. And of course, light.
The game is extremely cryptic.
And dark.
So what, you think I'm just gonna come along and be like, oh, I know exactly what they're saying?
No, the goal for me, I mean, is to
then,
learn
from the dark,
what the fuck is going on.
Came and found the souls of lords within the flame.
Future bosses.
Nito, the first of the dead.
Spoilers!
Spoilers for 2009 game!
The Witch of Izalith and her Daughters of Chaos. Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight, and his faithful knights.
Best armor in the game.
And the furtive pygmy, so easily forgotten.
Pygmy! Pygmy elephants are so cute.
With the strength of lords, they challenge the dragons. Gwyn's mighty lords peeled apart their stone skins. Witches weaved great firestorms. Nito unleashed a miasma of death. The scales betrayed his own, and the dragons were no more.
Was that a lot like fairy tale?
Was that Is that Agnolia?
Yes, that was Agnolia.
Thus began the Age of Fire.
Why would it begin the Age of Fire if all the dragons are dead?
There's but a plot soon, reason for that.
The flames will fade, and only dark will remain. Even now, there are only embers. And man sees not light, but only endless nights. And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side.
Racist.
Yeah, right.
See, like, just watching that, I learned some stuff about Dark Souls 3 that I just realized.
Ew.
Use your boss.
Yes, indeed. The dark side brands the undead. And in this land, the undead are corralled and led to the north. Where they are locked away to await the end of the world.
Lock up zombies? Why don't you just kill them?
Because they're undead.
Undead zombies, you kill them again.
This is your fate.
Well, do you want to keep killing them, or do you just want to lock them up and never deal with them again?
Ew.
Welcome to Guantanamo Bay.
Right? Oh, right. Thank you?
Okay, so the adventure begins.
Yeah.
Okay, so quick note, two things. One, push A for okay, and look at your character, like spin the camera around. I'm glad you spent so much time in character creation, because that's what you're going to look like for about 99% of the game. A zombie.
Oh my god, I'm fucking gross. Alright.
Second off, Dark Souls is really cryptic, so press start.
Fuck that.
Press start. And go to, browse and use items. Scroll over to the right with the D-pad. And press X.
God damn. X. I'm pressing it. Oh,
that's X. This is an Xbox controller. So it's good to read the item descriptions for all the items you pick up, because it will save your life and save you a ton of headache. So, dungeon cell key, a key to the dungeon of the undead asylum to the north. A mysterious knight, without saying a word, shoved a corpse down into the cell, and so its person, and on its person was this key. Who was this knight? What was his purpose? There may be no answers, but one must still forge ahead. Also, like, almost 100% of the lore of Dark Souls is told through these item pickups. See, like, you learn fire comes from pyro, from the Great Swamp.
Fair enough. Where's that ring? Is it equipped already?
Yeah, and you can push X to find out, like, the purpose of it. Ring made of an ancient tiny red jewel grants small increase to HP. Man, that's all.
Okay.
Push B again. And read the message.
The camera control.
break your broken sword.
Yeah.
R3 locks onto them.
Doing great, guys.
Yep.
Thumbstick hold B to dash. But yeah, if you guys are wondering why I sound like I'm so bad at controllers, I almost never play the Xbox, so...
Just imagine it's a PlayStation controller.
Not helping.
How good are you at geography and mental maps?
What?
I'm just saying, because there's no maps in this game, and it's all interconnected, so it might help to be good at geography.
Hi.
I'm gonna try to like interfere as little as possible just so I can keep the element of adventure. But this is pretty much a checkpoint, it's where you save your game and stuff.
Is the save option available right now?
No, it's auto saved.
Oh, cool. Alright. Get myself killed! Right, I remember you!
Yeah, this is pretty much close to where you got up to last time in the first game.
I fought this guy.
Run through the door.
Oops, wrong button.
And roll with B. I don't know if they didn't, if they gave you like a...
Nope.
Not that door.
Oh. Which
that
door?
To the left. You can roll through those.
Seems stupid. Why? Why'd you put a boss that I can't beat?
I mean, you could beat it. If you took the fire bombs as your starting gift, you could kill it. But it's kind of useless, you're gonna kill it anyway. It's past the door.
Yeah.
Run into that room.
Oh.
So to equip items, you gotta press start. Scroll over to press right bumper. Change equipment. Background sheet.
Yay.
And begin to close the menu.
Oh.
I feel like that's gonna kill you eventually.
What, having a menu open?
Yeah.
A lot of things are gonna kill me. Come here, bitch. Come here, bitch. Come here, bitch.
I would equip that too.
Yeah, it's an act. So. Wait. Okay, that's not how you do it. Wait. Oh, fucking hell.
Soon, muscle memory will kick in. B!
Oh, right.
I'm telling you, that's gonna kill you. You're gonna be in the middle of a boss fight, and it's gonna kill you. Target him!
Got him. Good enough.
Usually these white light fog doors lead to boss fights, but, yep.
Can climb.
What is jumping?
That's what I thought.
Thoughts so far?
What?
Thoughts so far?
Oh, I still hate it.
It's Dark Souls! I would take a look at... Yeah. Behind you.
Oh.
Oh, you. You're no Hollow. Thank goodness. I'm done for, I'm afraid. I'll die soon, then lose my sanity. I wish to ask something of you.
Kill you?
You and I, we're both undead.
It's all fine.
Hear me out, will you?
Sure.
Regrettably, I have failed in my mission. But perhaps you can keep the torch lit. There is an old saying in my family.
So much want, or I kill you.
And thine exodus from the undead
is
thine. Maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient.
If you go around attacking people, you usually
thou ringeth the bell
die
of
right. One of it.
Of the undead, thou shalt know.
Or ruin your
lives. And I can die with hope in my heart. Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. An Estus flask. An undead favorite.
So these are the main healing items in the game.
And to use my press down on the bump?
No, you press X.
I press X to use them. Alright.
Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now. And thank you.
And you should keep talking to him, because with Dark Souls you want to exhaust all their dialogue.
Now I must bid farewell.
Because sometimes you talk to him five times, he'll say something different and give you something.
So go now. And thank you. No, I would hate
Okay. So if I go there now, the same thing.
Nope.
R3. Great, thank you. What the fuck? What was that?
Press X to recover, by the way. I want you to take note of how long it takes you. Like, watch, press X.
Oh.
God damn it, Andrew, it's an Xbox controller.
Keep pressing A.
So healing in the middle for... Dark Souls 1 healing takes a long ass time. You'll notice once you try to heal in the middle of a boss fight.
Why two weapon?
So if you two-hand a weapon, it does more damage. Also, it requires less strength to use it, but you don't have a shield. It's hard to pull off. But it guard breaks.
Like I know what that is.
If somebody's holding a shield and you kick them, it'll knock the shield out.
Ah. Oh! Please do not shoot me point blank in my face. Get off the
victim.
You guys are just saying too much now.
I would target him. And don't block, because even with a shield, he's gonna kill you.
Ah, like that. Yay!
If you look at your shield stat, it gives you a breakdown of how much physical damage you can block. That one is not 100% block.
Gotcha.
You do get one. If you were a knight, you would have gotten it.
Anything and everything can kill me now.
Good, that's the right mentality.
Think he's gonna give me anything?
Nope, those events that took place always just, even after you died, they still took place.
I'm like,
don't worry, it's not there.
Before you start going all like Wolverine, like, what's that cover? Oh, okay, cool.
Ragdoll physics.
I feel like that shouldn't have hit him.
A lot of weapons have surprising range.
Alright, come here.
So what they want you to do is go behind him and quick attack him.
Okay.
The best way to go behind him is target him with R3 and strafe behind him. R3 him. Goddamn, Andrew, you're not following what it wants you to do.
Oh. Sorry.
You're breaking the tutorial.
Wait, R3?
R3 targets enemies and allows you to circle around them so you're not flailing wildly at nothing.
Oh, I already thought I targeted him. You see, I get caught up in the action so much that I don't really... Yeah, I'm gonna stop talking.
R3.
Shut up!
You gotta give commentary, you can't just fight a boss silently.
I need a focus. Oh, are you fine?
One more hit.
Uh-oh. Get up.
Just hit him.
Yeah.
See? It's not so scary.
No. That's not the boss I had a problem with. I mean, I did have a problem with that boss in the first place.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Because
the one after.
The, There is no boss after.
There's like a dragon thing you have to fight. Monster thing. You'll see what I mean.
Like 20 hours down the game? I don't know what you're talking about. I know you didn't play that far.
You'll see what...
Or you wait for the cutscene.
Only in the ancient legends it is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen.
Be eaten?
The end.
Alright, that's the end of the game. You have beaten Dark Souls.
To leave the undead asylum.
It's like Lord of the Rings.
Which I've never seen. Don't hate me, guys.
To the land joke. Of the ancient lords. Lordran.
Dot. Oh, kono stress.
Yeah, the bird's like glitching out.
You just see me flying my like I'm just hanging.
The bird is like, I can't handle 60 frames per second right now. I wasn't built for this.
Bird's like, peace.
So this is the main hub area that connects the whole. Yes. So, when it comes to leveling up, I would say the most important thing is endurance, and vitality increases life. You can always like preview what you increase if you just click right on anything.
Endurance, I'm assuming, increases like my stamina bar I have.
Endurance, like watch, press right, right. Endurance increases all of that shit. It increases your defense to everything, it increases your stamina, and it increases your equipment load.
Jesus!
And it increases your bleed resist.
Like,
it's ridiculously broken in Dark Souls 1.
Yeah, why does it increase so, so much?
It increases literally over
why? I would just put everything in endurance.
That's pretty much what you do. I mean, you need stuff like strength and dexterity for weapons, vitality for health, but everything else is endurance. Everything else is endurance.
Wait, how many points do I get to use?
You have 2,400 souls, and it tells you how many required souls per level. It goes up every time you level.
So, one, then another one, then one for vitality. Or is that too much?
No, that sounds good to me. I would never put anything into humanity or resistance, intelligence, or faith unless you need to because you're trying to cast a spell. Oh. Or definitely not attunement.
What's attunement?
Attunement lets you carry more spells, but you, as a pyromancer, you start with 2 spell slots, and that's pretty much all you're gonna need.
Oh, right. Yeah, it's so broken. Yeah.
In later games, it's like broken up into 2 different stats because it's so broken.
Yeah, they're like, alright, we learned our lesson.
Well, what do we have here? You must be a new arrival. Let me guess. Fate of the undead, right? Well, you're not the first, but there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the undead asylum. But too late now. Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are, actually, 2 bells of awakening. One's up above in the undead church. The other is far, far below. In the ruins at the base of Blight Town.
Blight Town!
And something happened. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on. But I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land, the undead.
Alright.
Ah, your face. You're practically hollow.
Fuck you.
I don't know. Going hollow could solve quite a bit.
Okay.
What? Restoring your humanity?
You're just gonna mock me or
well,
give me shit.
Well, there are a few ways to go about it. Collect it bit by bit from corpses.
Do anyways, like, skip the text?
Or you
like,
can butter up a cleric. And the
okay,
quickest
thank
way,
you.
Although I'd never do it, is to kill a healthy undead and pillage its humanity. Coveting thy neighbor is only human, after all.
Yeah, can I just kill him? I'm pretty sure he'll just kill me.
What are you looking at? Don't try anything clever.
Okay.
Wow.
You might
it's like he read my mind.
Yeah. Don't mess with him.
Hmm? What? Oh, that's all. Well, listen, one of the bells is up above in the undead church, but the lift, you have to climb the stairs up the ruins and access the the other bell is back down below within the plinth, but I'd die again before I step foot in that set.
Okay, I don't want to talk to you anymore.
Yeah, so I'm not going to tell you where to go, and why don't you just explore?
Fuck yeah. Let's see, I have to go up. Oh, I got giant raven thing still there.
That's his house. The better question is, what are you doing in this giant raven's house, Andrew?
Hello there. I believe we are not acquainted. I am Petrus of Thoroland. If not, I'd prefer...
Asshole.
Hello there. I realize that I have requested that we return, but I also want you to know that it is not meant in ill will. Here, take this.
Oh, what a non-asshole he is.
No, go ahead. It's for you.
Is that money?
No.
Can I break these things?
Yes. Why do you want to be so disgusting?
I'm looking to see if there's items in there.
Alright, since you'll miss it otherwise, go back down those stairs. Take a right. Jump down.
I saw it, but I'm just like, I don't want to jump down and die. Oh. Wow.
Yep.
Hey. I don't know what that is, but hey.
There's one more behind that. Yeah.
Don't know what that is either.
You should like look them all up.
I will. Jesus. Was that? Did you just get that?
No.
This black crystal, long a symbol of farewell, is granted to banish undead. The crystal sends phantoms back to their homes or sends you back to yours. Beware a fickle use of this item if you intend to nurture relations.
Cryptic! It's a PvP item. It's multiplayer.
Okay. Homeward bone fragment reduced. White ash, return to last bonfire used for resting. Ooh, that is very good. Bonfires are fueled by bones of the undead. In rare cases, the strong urge of their previous owners to seek bonfires enchants their bones with a homeward instinct. Soul of a lost undead who has long ago gone hollow, used to acquire souls.
That's money.
Ah. Souls are a source of life, and whether undead or even hollow, one continues to seek them. Humanity. Rare tiny black sprite found on corpses. Used to gain one humanity and restore a large amount of HP. Is this like a healing spell?
It's a PvP item, but also, more importantly, you can use it on bonfires and it'll increase amount of those recovery Estus flasks that you get when you rest on a bonfire.
Alright. This black sprite's called humanity, but little is known about its true nature. The soul is the source of all life, then what distinguishes the humanity we hold within ourselves? This is like Kingdom Hearts, but less fun.
Either.
Like, as in, like, the overall feel is just, like, so down.
Well, it's not an upbeat game.
Copper coin, coin made of copper.
great so far.
I know, right? It shows old man McLoif, god of medicine and drank. Even coins of great value in the world of men have little value in Lordran, where the accepted currency is souls. Those who dream of returning to the outside world are fond of carrying these around. And dark sign signifies the accursed undead. Those branched with it are reborn after death, but will one day lose their mind and go hollow. Death triggers dark sign, which returns its bearer to last bonfire rested at, but at the cost of all humanity and souls.
And weapons are
Nope. Here we go. Blah 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 blah. Okay, nothing. Yeah, there's nothing much worth saying about these.
So far, nothing super special.
Yeah.
That you might want to equip. That's your pyromancy item.
Yeah. Flame medium used by Great Swamp Pyromancers. Pyromancers about this flame to produce various fire arts. Did I first like use item?
Actually, no. You press B, or you press RB, sorry. And you equipped it in the same hand that you equipped your shield. To the right. Because you can hold two items in that hand.
Oh. I thought you had Fireball.
Fireball is a spell. It's automatically equipped. You can only equip it at a bonfire.
Oh, okay.
So, press B. If you press left on the D-pad, you can switch to your pyromancy hand. Yep. And then
I can
left
use...
trigger for Fireball.
Oh.
But make sure you're locked on, because that you definitely need to be locked on for. Otherwise, you just throw it randomly.
Ooh, where did I get that?
I'll save you the trouble. It's a PvP item.
Thank you. Do I keep going down in that one place?
Yep. It's the only way out.
Yeah. I was just like, I better ask if I just fall to my death. Yeah, like that. I'm running.
Can we grab that item down there?
Not to take a dive! Oh, shit.
Leave me alone. Leave me alone!
No, I didn't mean to do that! Oh, am I poisoned?
That is bleed. Once it fills up, you bleed out.
Is it still after me?
I don't know, look behind you.
asshole. Ah!
Oh god, why are there two of them? Yes!
Just leave me alone.
I mean, they might just walk back up and fight you again.
Can I hit them from here with fireballs?
No, they're too far out.
Fuck. Well, that was great, guys. That was awesome. That was
Wait, I want to see if they do follow you back up. Oh my god, they do. They're persistent.
Holy shit. No, I change to fireballs.
Left. On D-pad. Target them with R3. Oh, never mind.
No.
Target with the R3.
No,
stop.
I keep
dripping. Hitting. What are you doing?
I keep hitting X. No.
Why are you pressing X?
I can't stop myself.
You fought a giant demon. You can take on a couple of skeletons.
Can I heal myself? Where is it? Where did it go?
I'm totally naming this episode something about skeletons. There's something about skeletons. Oh my god, I hope you go to like a new area and there's like a game bug or something where they just keep chasing you for the rest of the game.
There's just so many new